Boa tarde, good afternoon, welcome back to the channel, bem-vindo. Hoje, or today, we're going to talk about a very interesting topic, and that is how to save money and how to pay yourself first methodology so that you can invest that money for the long term and meet your goals. Stay tuned, let's start. Okay, so in this video, we're going to talk about the method of paying yourself first. This will afford you the opportunity to save money and, importantly, invest it for the long term in order to live comfortably in the future. So let's get started. Okay, so how does pay yourself budgeting or the methodology work in the first place? Okay, step one, first, you're going to have to basically assess what you're spending your money on. So that includes everything. So each day, each week, every month, look at what your expenses are, what you're spending your money on currently. Now, step two is really determining on what to pay yourself first. So most experts, and I would agree with this, look at about 20% of your earnings should be paid to yourself first. Now, thirdly, you need to identify your saving goals. So, are your goals, we talked about this in the Investing for Beginners video, what are the goals that you have for yourself? So really that's step three. So are they short-term goals or more sort of longer-term goals that you have? And that could just change your philosophy on the types of investments and what you're saving for in the first place and have that commitment. So what are the pros and what are the cons of this pay yourself methodology, saving for yourself so that you can invest for the short or the long term? Let me go through the pros first. Number one, the pay yourself first budgeting method is low maintenance, very low maintenance, compared with a lot of other complicated budgeting schemes that are out there. And secondly, it doesn't require you to categorize every single expense or keep a detailed record of everything that you're spending on. Once you've got this happening, once you get rolling on this plan, you don't need to do those things. Also, some of the pros of doing this is can help you focus on the big picture. And that's what we should all be doing anyways when we're looking at investing and looking at our future and our goals, is really keep your eye on the big picture, and that can help you have that level of commitment and conviction about what you're doing. So also, when you have an eye on that big picture, it'll reduce the impulsiveness of spending on unnecessary items. Do you really need every single iPhone that is released? I ask that question to myself. I say no. I say maybe every third or fourth release, I'll get a new iPhone. Okay, so what are some of the other pros is you can automate this. So automation is a simple way to pay yourself first. And so you can set up the contributions from your salary and so on and so forth to automatically be deposited into a savings account where you can then use it for your investments. One of the other pros that I've found is that one of the things you can do, mostly in all banks, okay, including the bank I represent, you can have multiple types of accounts. And then what you can do, you have your day-to-day checking account, the money that you need to sort of pay the bills, if you will, and then you have poupanças or savings accounts where you can then transfer money from your payroll or your earnings from your business into more of a poupança or savings type account. So that can be set up very easily. So those are the pros of doing the pay yourself methodology. Now let's discuss some of the cons or some of the negatives that are associated with this type of planning. And there's not a whole lot, but there are a few. So one of the things that happens is when you're prioritizing savings over other goals, you might not always be in your best financial interest. Now what do I mean by that? For example, if you have toxic debt, and we talked about this in the Investment for Beginners video, if you have a lot of debt, such as high interest credit cards, car loans, and stuff like that, we recommend tackling or destroying that debt or reducing it. Sorry for the strong words, but that's how I feel about debt, and you should too. Get rid of that toxic debt first. So we recommend that, you know, essentially before saving up for a vacation or a new car or something like that. We even suggest classifying your debt payments as savings to help reduce or resolve those debt issues. Okay, so that are some of the, those are just a couple of the small cons of actually paying yourself first. So in the end, it's pretty short take, ready, set, save. Okay, so paying yourself first is a great option if you prefer sort of a hands-off budgeting system or a complicated budgeting system, or you just don't feel as though you're budgeting at all. So remember to automate your savings, to be paying yourself 20% of what you earn, what your income is on a monthly basis. And believe me, you will get used to the adjustment. You'll be, you know, spending a little bit less. You'll be thinking that you're earning a little bit less money, but we always adjust. We always adjust. The reverse problem that we see a lot of clients do, or a lot of people in general do, is when they get a promotion or they get a pay raise, they spend up to the top of that pay raise. So if you're earning more money and you have a bigger income, we see a lot of people just expand their spending, when in fact, you should be expanding your savings, because you can invest that money, make a lot of money for yourself, if allocated appropriately, of course. And there's no promises here. That wasn't a prediction or a crystal ball by any stretch. But basically, you know, if you do need a little bit more structure instead of just putting aside that 20% per month, you can have like a what we call an envelope system, and that basically portions out a little bit of extra income off your earnings. I'll cover that in a future video, but the bottom line is that you are your most important asset. Your ability to stay healthy, make a living, run a business, you know, run a foundation, contribute to a charitable cause of that is attached to your passion. And so you should always be paying yourself first. So aim for that 20% from your income and your earnings, wherever that comes from, and put that aside for yourself first. And then of course you can invest that and expand that money. So make your money work for you. That's the title of the channel that you're on right now. So let's use that and put it to good use. Thank you for joining me today, and please subscribe if you haven't already, and tap that bell for future notifications of videos that I'll be rolling out on a weekly basis. Thanks again from Rio de Janeiro. This is Larry.